Hey everybody, thanks for coming back and watching another video. If you haven't been here before, please make sure to hit the subscribe button, hit that little bell notification so you see when new videos come up. This channel is all about everything electric bikes. So today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about brakes. Electric bikes are often heavier than standard bicycles, and they travel at average speeds that are higher. So it makes perfect sense that you should have more stopping power as well. But many of the affordable brands come with standard mechanical disc brakes. Those would include the Saunders bikes, the Rad Power bikes, the Taga family bike. All of those are good examples of an electric bike that is fast enough or heavy enough that they could use a bit more stopping power than what they come with. Normally, you could go to any bike shop, pick up a set of hydraulic brakes, they can install them in a matter of minutes, really, and you'd be on your way. But with an electric bike, you run into a few challenges. Number one would be brake switches. Most electric bikes have a brake switch built into the lever, so that way when you pull it, it cuts power to the motor. It's a safety feature, and it's even a law required in some states. Now, if you buy a pair of standard hydraulic brakes, they're not going to have any kind of electrical switch on them whatsoever. And if they do, and they're made for an electric bike, odds are they're not going to have a plug that matches the bike that you have. Problem number two would be the length of the cables. Sometimes the hydraulic lines are not long enough. The Rad Wagon is a good example of that. Because of the long cargo tail, a typical hydraulic brake is not going to have a line that's nearly long enough to reach that rear wheel. It's only going to reach the front. Sometimes you also have people who don't want to lose their stock brake levers. In the case of the Rad Power bikes and some others, they have the Textro brake levers on them that have an integrated bell. If you change your brakes, that's something you're going to lose. Obviously, you can add another bell, there's ways around it, but there's a lot of little inconveniences that add up to make it to where I see a lot of people want better stopping power, but they don't have an easy solution. Thankfully, there is a solution, however. So this is the Juintech hydraulic caliper. So this is the M1, and what this is a caliper that you can install on a bike that has cable brakes. So basically, you're gonna keep your stock levers. The brake switches are not going to be affected. The lines and the lengths are not going to be changed. You keep all of those in place. All you're going to do is remove the existing mechanical caliper and replace it with this new hydraulic caliper. So that means this brake can fit on virtually any e-bike that has mechanical disc brakes. So very easy to install. So let's go ahead and take this Rad Rover that I have behind me, and I'll show you how simple it is to put these on. Here we are close up to the stock Rad Rover mechanical caliper. So we're going to remove the caliper from the bike so we can loosen up the steel cable. And then we're going to need to remove the cable crimp on the end. You can either grab a pair of pliers and try and pull that straight off, or if you have enough length, you can always cut the cable right up next to it, but you want to leave as much as you possibly can on that steel line. Now there's going to be some slight variance between bikes. So the new calipers do come with brake disc adapters. It's going to depend on your bike and the size of the rotors you have, which ones fit. Odds are the adapters, at worst case scenario, that are already on your bike are going to work. So either use the ones that come with it or the adapters already installed your bike, whichever one fits best. So we can move the cable out of the way. And then we can remove the two bolts on the caliper and go ahead and take that one completely off the bike. Because I'm going to use the stock adapter, I removed the one off the Juintech caliper. We'll pop this spacer out. Make sure not to squeeze this while this is out. Otherwise, you'll be fighting to spread those back apart. And all we're gonna do is line this guy up and put our bolts back on. Now we have the caliper almost all the way on. You can see just a little bit of wiggle room. So all I'm gonna do is squeeze this lever here, which is normally connected to the brake line. We're not connected yet. And while I'm squeezing that, I'm going to tighten those two bolts down. And with the hydraulic calipers like this, both sides of the pad move in to squeeze the brake disc. On a mechanical pad, you typically have only one side that moves and the other is stationary. So by having both move in, we can squeeze that lever in. It gets centered on the disc, and then once we let go, both pads are gonna move off, and odds are it's gonna be adjusted perfectly the first time. Now we're gonna take the cable that we pulled out earlier. We'll slip it through right here, and that's gonna sit right down in there. And then we are just going to loosen this up. We'll run this right through the space here. And we'll just get a little bit of pressure on that and tighten it back down. And we don't want our cable to get frayed, so we'll want to put a new crimp on the end of that. And that's it, we're done. We may have some slight adjustments to do. There's an adjustment knob right here on the caliper itself. And then of course you still have the adjustment for the cable tension up by your lever as well. For the adjustment on the bottom here, if you turn to the right, basically righty-tighty, lefty-loosey, to the right is gonna bring the pads closer together, and to the left is gonna bring them further apart. And as I mentioned, you still have the adjustment up here next to the lever itself. Now the advantage to this and the main difference, and this is really awesome, normally on a mechanical brake, when you adjust this up here, it's gonna bring one pad closer to the disc and the other pad remains stationary. But because of that unique design of those hydraulic calipers, when you adjust this, so when your pads start to feel a little loose, you can actually just add some tension right here and it's gonna bring both of your pads in closer. So super easy to adjust. Like all hydraulic brakes, however, they're self-adjusting, so you're really not gonna have to adjust them that much. As the pads wear down, you may tighten it up just a tiny bit or as your cable stretch a little, but far less adjustment versus standard mechanical brakes. And as you can see how simple that was, really, really easy to install. We still have our stock levers, we've got our bell right here. We haven't changed the cable housing or anything. So it can't get much easier than that. The process is gonna be exactly the same for the rear brake. So once again, we have two bolts on the top of the caliper. So we're gonna loosen those, remove the stock caliper. We have to loosen up this one bolt here to release the cable. And then we're just gonna drop the new hydraulic caliper on. Have the new caliper with the adapter removed. We're gonna use the one on the bike again. Pop that spacer out. Put our bolts through. And just like the front, I leave just a little bit of wiggle room. Squeeze those pads together, pulling on the lever there, and tighten it down the final amount. I've run the cable through here, run the steel line through the holder in the back. We'll make sure to put a new crimp on that when we're done. Okay, so we'll give that just a little bit of tension and tighten that down.
crimp that guy on. And we're all done.
If that is not the easiest hydraulic brake conversion you've ever seen, I don't know what is. So now I'm gonna take the bike outside, give it a little spin, see how much fun it is with a little bit extra stopping power. So coming down this hill, should be able to get over 20 miles an hour pretty easily on just throttle, just because it's downhill. So I'm gonna get as close as I can, and at the last minute, slam on the brakes and see what happens. Thanks again for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. I'll make sure to put some other videos over here or maybe over there, but lots of cool e-bike stuff going on all the time. I will have more videos about the Rad Rover. In particular, now that we've made it stop better, it's time to make it faster.